next chapter, that is chapter number 6, properties of seawater. Yes, here is our screen, students. So let's start our new chapter today, properties of seawater. Yes, so before starting the main chapter, let's recall or let's solve these questions which they have given as a previous knowledge. See the first one here. First question, first one, which is the largest water storage of the world? As we are going to study about the properties of seawater, so here there is one type of question that as a general knowledge we should be able to understand and we should know that which is the largest water storage of the world. So, and the second question is, why is the seawater salty? Yes, why is the seawater salty? This question, you all can take it as learning outcome also. At the end of the chapter, we will be able to understand what are the answers of these questions. So, the first question's answer is, that which is the largest water storage of the world? The answer is Jeddah is the largest water storage of the world, which you can see the images on your screen. Yes, largest drinking water storage facilities, which is in Jeddah, that is in Saudi Arabia. So this was the first question that we need to recall as a previous knowledge. Then, why is the seawater salty? Yes, you can see the most amount of salt is being there on the sea level. Yes, so why it is salty? In most of the time, this question, when you are enjoying on the seaside, yes, most of the time these questions have arisen in your mind that about the salty water. How the seawater is salty. So how and it should be, what is the reason? The answer for this is, student, that decomposition of minerals and salts has made seawater salty. You can see the persons, how they are separating the salts. Yes, you can see the most amount of the salt here. These two images you can see. As in the earlier classes also, we have studied about the tides, ocean currents, then with reference to oceans also. In this lesson, we will study the major properties of seawater. So today, we are going to start with the properties of seawater. There are some main properties that we should able to understand what are the qualities and characteristics of the seawater. So seawater is water from a sea or an ocean. It covers more than 70% of the earth's surface. Seawater is a complex mixture. Seawater is a complex mixture of approximate 96.5% water plus 2.5% of salt, other substances too, including dissolved inorganic or organic materials also, and a few atmospheric gases. This all includes in the seawater, which is a water we get it from the sea or a ocean. And on the earth, more than 70% of the earth's surface is covered with the seawater, and it is a complex mixture. So here we have understood about the seawater. Seawater, just keep it in a point wise, you have to keep it in your mind. It is a complex mixture of 96.5% of water, 2.5% of salt, and other smaller amounts of other substances. Yes, and also it includes what, students? Atmospheric, gaseous, as well as inorganic or organic materials also. So this year, what we have understood about the simple meaning of the sea water. Okay, let's start the properties of the sea water. So here, there are three main major properties of seawater. First is temperature, second salinity, and third is density. So these three are the major properties of seawater. So one by one we are going to study in detail. As well as in this lesson, we are going to have one small experiment also, one activity we can say. It will be very interesting. So let's start with the first major properties of seawater, that is temperature. Yes, temperature. This word is most the word is very familiar with all of the students. Yes, so let's study the first major property of seawater. Let's read the first point. Temperature is a major property of the seawater. The surface temperature of the seawater is not uniform everywhere. This is dependent on different factors. So students, here in the first point, what they have explained, there are some different factors. The temperature is not equal at a time. It is continuously, it is not stable, it is not uniform everywhere. Okay, so this you have to understand, that temperature, the surface temperature of the seawater is not always uniform, and it depends on the different factors. Second point, latitudinally speaking, the surface temperature of the seawater decreases from the equatorial areas towards the poles. The average temperature in equatorial areas is around 25 degrees Celsius. It is 16 degrees Celsius in mid latitudes, while it is about 2 degrees Celsius near the poles. See, this point tells you about the heat zones. There are some different types of heat zone, students. In your previous classes also, you have studied about the different types of zones. Yes, torrid zone, Tropic of Cancer, Tropic of Capricorn. So we are going to study that to understand this second point. Yes, see, this is about the second point which we have read just now. To better understanding, we will study through this diagram. This diagram tells you about the different types of zones. See, this is the frigid zone over here. Yes, then tempered zone, torrid zone. Yes, this three zones we have to study to understand the major property of seawater, that is temperature. See here. Let us understand now. There are different types of heat zones on the earth. If we see this equator, this observably, very keenly you observe, students, this equator. Middle of the earth means this equator line, that is 0 degrees Celsius, this one. And the above of the equator, in the north side, yes, this side, Arctic Circle, which is in, this is north side and this is south side. When we go towards the north side, what we will able to, what which storage zone you can see here? You can see the frigid zone, tempered zone. This is the zone in the earth that is torrid zone, this zone. Torrid zone receive most of the sun rays. This zone is the region the temperature is more over here. In this torrid zone, you can see the temperature is too high. This one, torrid zone. If we move toward the northern sides of the equator and the southern side of the equator, the heat reduces. The temperature of the earth reduces also. See here, when we take a point from the equator side to the north side, this side. Here you can see the first zone, you can see a lot of temperature is there, more temperature. When we move forward, yes, when we go in this zone, that is tempered zone, here you can see the greenery over there. Yes, the temperature zone, which is in green color, here you can see the temperature is reduced. The heat is less over here in this tempered zone, as well as in the northern side also, and this in the southern side of the zone also, in this tempered zone. Here you can see the heat is less as compared to the torrid zone. There, if the temperature here is more, so the sea water is hot in this region. If the temperature is low, then the sea water will be cool in this region. So here, according to the temperature, the region, it will be changed. The region's climatic change will can be seen over there. One more image of the different types of heat zones. Here you can see the equator side, the middle part of the earth, which is the, and here, which is in 0 degrees Celsius. You can see here the middle part of the earth, that is the equator, 0 degrees Celsius. Between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, this region is called as torrid zone. Yes, the region you can see, it is in red color. This region is the torrid zone. If we move away from the equator to the northern side or the southern side, the region you can see that is tempered zone. Here the heat is less. So with this, we can understand the first major type of property of seawater, that is temperature. With these two images, you can easily able to write it in your own words about the first major property of seawater. So let's have some geographical explanation more about the temperature. Yes, see the first point. Besides this, cyclones, rainfall, sea waves, ocean currents, salinity, pollution, convectional currents, seasons, etc. also affect the surface temperature. Ocean currents also have similar effects on temperature of the seawater. The first point it tells us about that how the surface of the temperature of ocean currents, how they affects on it due to the cyclone, due to the sea waves, low tides, high tides, as well as through the pollution also. The surface of the temperature of ocean currents, it affects on the temperature of the seawater. Second point here, in regions where the cold ocean currents flow, the surface temperature of ocean water is less, while the regions where the warm currents move, the temperature increases. Now here, in this, what we have understood that there are two types of currents over here, warm currents and cool currents. These two currents you will be able to see when we are learning more in the depth about the oceans. In some of the regions where there is a cold ocean, that time you can see the currents is the current flow of that ocean is in the temperature, it is very less when there is a cold ocean current. If the temperature is more, the temperature starts increasing, that time you can see the warm currents over there. Then yes, after that, while most of the sun rays radiate back from the surface of the sea, some of them penetrate to certain depths in the water. See, first here you can see the radiate means what? To produce heat or light. Radiate means to produce heat or light. And one more word, it is penetrate. Penetrate means to move into or through something which we are moving, which is we are in the moving state, that you can see is that we can understand that is penetrate. So here the first point what they have explained, while most of the sun rays radiate back from the surface of the sea, most of them penetrate to certain depth in the sea. Now let's talk about the sea water's depth. In depth we are speaking about the temperature. Firstly, what we have studied, the surface of the temperature of sea water. Now what they are explaining us about the sea water, how the temperature depth of the water is there, that we can see. Here you can see the image, students. See, you can see the sun rays which is there on only on the surface of the sea water. When we go down, you can see dark over there. When we swim deeply it inside in the sea water, you can see there is a darkness over there. Yes, only on the surface you can see the sun rays. And at the top of that sun rays, means this one, at the top of the sun rays, you can feel the temperature is very hot. But when we go inside in the sea water, that time you can see the temperature is decreased over there in the depth of the sea water. So here also they have explained us that as the result, the intensity of the sun rays is decreasing with increasing depth. The temperature decreases up to 2000 meter depth. After 2000 meter means 2 kilometers, the temperature of the sea water is uniform everywhere. When we go deep inside the sea water in the depth, that time you can see that the temperature of the sea water is uniform everywhere. But firstly, what we have studied, when we are talking about the surface, that time the temperature is not uniform. When we talk about the depth of the sea water, that time the temperature is uniform everywhere. Next, it is around 4 degrees Celsius everywhere, from the equatorial regions to the polar area. Equatorial areas means what? The areas which is near the equator. It is known as equatorial regions. The temperature reduces only up to 4 degrees Celsius according to the depth. Means according to the depth, if the depth is very too deep inside, according to it, the temperature will reduce. Yes, up to 4 degrees Celsius. And therefore the water at greater depths does not freeze. Means when the water is there in the deep inside, it does not freeze. It is about the first major property of seawater, that is temperature. So here what we have understood, that when the temperature of the seawater when it is on the surface, that time you can see the temperature is not uniform over there. Yes, when the temperature it decreases in the depth of the seawater, that time you can see darkness over there, and it about 2000 meter or 2 kilometers you can see the seawater temperature is uniform everywhere. Next, the temperature of the seawater changes rapidly with the depth at the equatorial area. The difference in temperature is lesser in polar areas. Yes, there is also difference in open seas and land seas. Yes, new two words you can see here: open seas and landlocked seas. Open seas means what? See students, we have two types of sea students. Yes, Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal. Yes, in Arabian Sea, the three sides of land it connects or it meets Indian Ocean. When we are talking about the Arabian Sea, that time three side of land it connects the Indian Ocean. Yes, and when we see about the Bay of Bengal Sea, it is covered by three sides of land and it is open. Yes, it can easily meet it Indian Ocean. So this is called as open seas, means the seas which can easily connect to the ocean. You can see it is open over there, means all the four sides of that seas it is open. You can see, we can understand that sea is known as open seas. Then what is landlocked sea? Landlocked sea means what? Landlocked sea means let's take an example of the Dead Sea, Baltic Sea or Mediterranean Sea, that is covered by the sides of land. This seas, Dead Sea, Baltic Sea and the Mediterranean Sea, this sea is covered with the side of the land which cannot easily flow. That is known as landlocked sea. This is true for low latitudinal areas. Yes, as the salinity of the landlocked sea is more, the temperature of these landlocked sea is higher than the open sea. You can see in the landlocked sea, the sea is locked over there. The sea is locked through the land. That time you can see the temperature, it is very high over there than the open sea. This is true for the low latitudinal areas only. If we take example of equatorial areas, the landlocked sea is there, the temperature is more. So because of this, land is covered by all four sides. There is no supply of fresh water. There is no supply of that in this landlocked sea. Cold water, and in the open sea, the temperature is less over there. If the sea is landlocked over there, that time we can understand there is no supply of fresh water you can see. But in open sea, it can happen over this. Yes. So till here we have understood about the first major property of seawater, that is temperature. So next second major property of seawater, that is the salinity. Yes, in this we are going to study more about the salt, about the how the seawater is salty. Yes, firstly we have studied in the previous knowledge the second question, why the seawater is salty. So for that correct good explanation with examples, we are going to see in this second point. So let's start here. Yes, salt is used in the food we eat. salt is also used for making various chemicals and medicines also. Yes, salt is used for the many purpose. To cook tasty food, we put it salt. Yes, for the great taste. For making various types of chemicals or medicines, there also we use this salt over there. So here, let's take one example on regular basis only. For example, pickles. If we want to store it, if we want to keep it for a longer period, students. So yes, what we add over there, we add salt in it. Yes, how the pickles, they store it. How they are last long over there because of the salt. When we want to preserve some things for a longer time, that time you can use salt over there. Then when we see the second point here, salt is also used to preserve things for longer period. Salt is also used in ice factories also. So here, why in the ice factories the salt is used? When we add the salt to ice, it doesn't melt. So it is used in the ice factories, like the ice cream. In the ice cream parlor also, you can see most of the ice creams, it is stored in that small refrigerator. Along that, if we add the salt to it, it will not melt easily. Yes, then we obtain salt from the salt pans. The BOAC of the seawater increases because of salinity. This is useful for water transport. But if the salinity is more than the bearable limits, the life in water gets destroyed over there. Now here in the new word, you can see this is BOAC. BOAC means what? The ability of something to float it in the water. BOAC means ability to float it in water. That is known as BOAC. The BOAC of the water increases because of the salinity. This is useful for water transport. So as we know, student, that we cannot walk on the seawater. Yes, because we are walking on the seawater, the density is more over there. We will go down if we walk on the seawater. If there are some objects that can float on the seawater, their density is less as compared to the seawater. But because of this BOAC, the ability to float it in water, salinity from under the water, the force applies over there. Because of the force, any objects can float on the water. As the salinity is more, the BOAC will be more. If the salinity is more, the floating capacity in the water will be more. Yes? But if the salinity is less over there, there should be some limit for the salinity, students. Why? Because then there will be no life in the seawater. All the aquatic animals will die. See, example like Dead Sea. In that Dead Sea, nobody can survive because of more salinity. Then there is no life of aquatic animals over there. If the limit of the salinity is quite okay type, then animals, aquatic life will be there. If there is more salinity, you can see nobody can survive on that sea. So here was the explanation about the salinity, the second major type of seawater. After this, we are going to do an activity which is very useful for that, how the seawater is salty. Yes, through this activity we will able to easily understand. Yes, the first point. Try this. Take 1.5 liters of water in a big container. Put 100 gram salt in it and stir. Here you can take a big container like this. Yes, and put it 1.5 liter of water, and as well as after that put it salt also, and nicely you have to stir it, okay, properly. So after watching this, after learning this lesson, students, you can try this with your friends, with your classmates, as well as you can take help of your brother, sisters also. And I insist everyone to please do this activity to understand the property of seawater through this activity. So right now observe it carefully, as well as you can take the example, you can take the help of your textbook also. Yes, after taking the container, then we have to take, now take three containers of same size. Here you can see the containers which are in same size. To identify them, put three dots of different colors on them. To identify, you can identify like numbers you can put, or you can put some different initials, that we will able to understand that this container is, first we have identified number 1, 2, 3, and here also for 1 you can see the red dots, 2 pink dots, and for the 3 it is blue dots. To identify the containers, you have to put some different colors on the container to identify it. Then put the water containing salt equally in the 3 containers. Make sure the containers are half empty after filling the water. Then the first, what we have mixed water and salt nicely, we have stirred. After that, what we are going to do, we are going to put that water containing salt equally in the 3 containers. We have put that water in the 3 containers. Make sure the containers are half empty after filling the water. We have to see that when we put that water in that containers, in these 3 containers, we have to half empty after filling the water. We have to keep it like this, half water after filling it. Then taste the water out of the 3 containers. Keep one in the sun outside. Cover it with the mesh lid. After tasting the water out of the 3 containers, take the one container and you have to keep it under the sun outside the house. You have to keep this container, one container, you have to keep it outside the house. Yes, which you can see here on your screen, and it should be covered with the lid. Yes, then next, keeping the remaining 2 in the classroom, cover them with the net lids too. Put half a glass of fresh water daily in one of the containers in the classroom. So when one container is outside the classroom, outside the house, and the other 2 remaining are in the classroom only. And what they have said here, you have to put a half of glass of water daily, of fresh water. Daily you have to put half of the glass water in this container. Yes, and it should be covered with the lid. After 3 to 4 days, bring all the containers together at one place. Observe the level of the water in all the 3 containers. So this activity, it can take 5 to 6 days, students. Yes, because 3 to 4 days you have to keep that container at below the sun rays, outside the house or a classroom. And then you have to, after 3 to 4 days, you have to bring all the containers at one place. See how the students, they have assembled all the containers on one place. After observing the level of the water in all the three containers, first observe the level of the water, then taste it one by one. Yes, take a taste of one container, second, third. Experience the difference in the taste, write about all the three states in one line. When we will taste the first water, when we will taste the first container, the first the container which was in the sun rays, when we taste it, that time what we can see, as you can take the container A, which is outside of the house. Yes, when we taste that water from the container A, which is in the red dot, the water has decreased because of the evaporation under the sun. Only the salt is left. Means you can understand here, the salinity is more over there. Yes, the container which was outside, yes, which was outside under the sun rays, here what you can see, because of the sun rays, the water has decreased because of evaporation under the sun. Only the salt is left and the salinity here, it is more. So when we taste this container, the first container, which is in the red dots, A container, here what we have understood, that only the salt is left and the salinity is more over there, as the evaporation under the sun is there. Then let's talk about the next container, that is container B and C, means with pink dot container and the blue dot container. Daily fresh water we were putting it, so there will be no salinity. There will be no salinity, or you can say the salinity is more, and there is no heat at all. Yes, through this, in this container, there is no heat at all. So for the container 2 and 3, because daily we were putting the fresh water in that container, so your salinity is very less. So this was the example of the second major property of salinity. So with this we have understood that how the salinity of the seawater is more, is less due to the evaporation of the sun rays. So this was our activity, that through this activity we can easily understood about the salinity. So let's focus on the some points which they have given after this activity. First point, you must have realized that because of the sun's heat, evaporation happens at a faster rate. Because of the sun heat, the evaporation, it happens at a greater speed. Second point, evaporated water turns into the water vapor and reduces in the quantity, but amount of salt remains same in the remaining water, and therefore the salinity of the water increases. Yes, when the water which is evaporated and it turns into the water vapor, it reduces the quantity of the water. The amount of salt remain as it is only, but the salinity of the water increases. Yes, the salt's taste will be remain same in that remaining water. Yes, and that's why, this is the reason that salinity of the water is increased in that container A, red dots one. Okay, keep it in that mind. Third point, in seas where the rate of evaporation is high, then the supply of fresh water salinity is high. In seas, when the rate of the evaporation is high, students, yes, that time the supply of the fresh water, that is salinity, is high over there. In seas where the supply of fresh water exceeds the rate of evaporation, salinity is low. Yes, when there is a supply of fresh water and it exceeds, there is too much of fresh water over there, and it exceeds the rate of evaporation. That time you can see the salinity is very low over there. Then salinity is not affected much in seas where both the supply of fresh water and evaporation of water is low. Salinity is not affected in much seas, because where both of supply of fresh water and evaporation of water is low, here the salinity will not affect much in the seas. So after this activity, we have understood these points of the salinity. Okay, students. So here. So let's revise what we have studied at the very first of the lesson. Quickly, we are going to revise what we have learned. Yes. We have learned about the major properties of seawater. Today we have started it. First, we have studied about the temperature. Yes, temperature, it is a major property of seawater. And the surface of the temperature, the seawater is not uniform. Yes, when we are talking about the temperature of the surface, it is not uniform over there. There is no uniform everywhere. Then when we are talking about the depth of the sea water, when we go inside it, that time you can see the sea water is uniform everywhere. I mean, the temperature of the sea water is uniform over there. After that, we have studied about the landlocked seas. Landlocked seas means what? The sea which is covered by all the four sides by the land. That time you can see that sea is known as landlocked sea. For example, Dead Sea. Dead Sea is the example of landlocked sea. Then is open sea. Open sea we have talked about the Arabian Sea and Bay of Bengal. Yes, in the Bay of Bengal, it is covered by three sides. And easily it can connect to the other ocean. So this sea is known as open sea. Yes. Then the second major property of water, sea water, we have studied about the salinity. Salinity means what? It is about the salt. Yes. Through that experiment, we have easily understood about how the salinity of the sea water remains. What is the reason? Because of the evaporation, you can see there is salinity is more over there. Then at last we have done the experiment. We have done the activity on salinity. So I request all the students to do this activity, and you can take the actual experience of the salinity. Take your friends, take your brother, sister along with you and do it, students. It is quite interesting. You will like it. Yes. The last part of the lesson, that is the last session of today's session, that is evaluation. So there are some questions here that you have to note it down, or you can take the screenshot and solve it after the lecture. Yes, so here is the question you can see. See, first only we have studied why is the taste of the seawater salty? What are the factors affecting the salinity of the seawater? What are the factors affecting the temperature of the seawater? Explain the changes occurring the temperature of the sea water according to the depth. This fourth question, which is about the depth of the sea water. Yes, take the help of this session also, as well as your textbook, and solve it, students, as a evaluation part. You can write it in your own words also. So in the next lecture, as objective type questions, I'll ask you. So be prepared for it. So see you in for the next lecture. So thank you, students, for being very attentive and listening. I hope you have understood this first part of this lesson. And as we are going to continue tomorrow, the second part, that is on Monday. So please attend the lecture. So for the understanding this lesson in a better way. So thank you, students. Stay home, stay safe, and keep learning. See you, students.
Thank you, teacher. सो स्टूडेंट्स, हम यहाँ एक छोटा सा ब्रेक ले रहे हैं, उसके बाद 8:40 को लेक्चर स्टार्ट करेंगे. थैंक यू.